407 number is
Amy.
Audrey was good with Mary.
Okay. Alyssa's trying to get in too. So that's kind of what we're doing here tonight. We know that there's a lot of hesitations that come with this business because it's not your typical 9-to-5. So we wanted to address those as well. So I know that a lot of you guys have questions because I know when I started, so did I. And that is what we are here for. We want to have you guys make your own educated decisions about what this business is, if this is something that you could possibly be doing, and if you are doing it, how you could see how you can succeed even more in the business. We want you to make sure, we want to make sure that you're 100% confident when you're leading this group or this webinar tonight with having all of your questions answered. So please make sure you're using that chat box over there. I don't know, I guess it's in your left-hand corner. Anybody who's on the call, we will be recording this, and it's going to be put into the groups that you join through. So make sure you check back in there so you can see the slides if you wanted to see any of the slides. We will be trying to explain most of them for all those who are on the phone. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and start. So like I was saying, when I joined, I had a lot of hesitations about the business. When I started, I kind of started through a journey of, Bo and I had a wedding photography business in Orlando. By the way, I'm Brandy, if you guys don't know me. We had a wedding photography business in Orlando, and we got in a car accident. We had it for about 5 years, got in a really bad car accident, got rear-ended, and ended up with 3 herniated discs on my lower back and several on my neck. Well, after trying to push through that and physical therapy and everything other than surgery you can possibly think of, we had to shut down the wedding photography business because it's just something physically I was unable to do. Having said that, after that, we moved to New York, Albany, to be closer to Bo's family. Up here, I was in a lot of pain and hated my job and did a lot of driving, which did not help my back any further. So I wanted to find something that would help me with my back. And also, I was super depressed. I had no friends here. I was just searching for a lot of things, I think. And when I came across Pio, when I was searching for something to do with my back, some way, somehow to make my back stronger, I came across Pio. And along with that, I found the coaching opportunity. Well, if you know me by any means, I research everything to death. So I researched and researched and researched and researched this. I was reviewing some videos one night, and my husband, Bo, was next to me. I was reviewing some coaches, and I came across Lindsay Matway, who is my coach now, and he saw her over my shoulder, and he said, "Hey, why are you watching Lindsay?" And it just so happens, long story short, he went to school with Lindsay. So I saw that as a sign. I said, "Okay, let me sign up with her." And then I just kind of started my journey. And from there on, people were really following me on Facebook, seeing my journey, seeing my changes, seeing my transformations, which you see down there in Pio, and started kind of asking me about what coaching's about, what I was doing to make myself feel better. And I fell in love with the opportunity to be able to pay this forward to others. So along with the coaching opportunity and bringing people, you know, and coaches like Stephanie and Dina, who are super passionate about this as well and also want to pay this forward and with their health and fitness and getting, you know, how rewarding it is to be able to lift people up and above and beyond helping them with their fitness and their health journey, just breathing life into them. And I could go on and on about this. So I'm going to stop right there because I'm going to talk a little bit more about this in the future, in the next couple of slides, but I'm going to pass it over to Dina right now. And then we'll go on further from here.
Hi guys, I'm Dina. If you don't know me, and I just wanted to tell you a little bit about how I got started. I've always been in the fitness and nutrition world. That was my background in college. And I had kind of gotten away from eating healthy and working out, working a lot and just kind of fell out of it. And then I saw Brandy's journey on Facebook and it intrigued me. And so I started following her and I decided to join a challenge group and do Pio myself, and I fell in love with Pio first, and then I also fell in love with the challenge group and the support and motivation that I received from the group, and I was oh my God, this is what I want to do. I love fitness, I love nutrition, I love these challenge groups and what they do, and so I wanted to have a life by design and eventually make this my full-time job. Right now I am working full-time, but my spare time is committed to Beachbody for the most part. So it's just been such a great opportunity for me to help others and just be a forward, like Brandy said. So hopefully you guys will learn a lot tonight and be able to make a good decision on if it's right for you. Steph?
So I'm Stephanie, if you don't know me yet. I've been a coach since August or September last year when I joined in. And for me, I've been in the hospitality industry. I'm 28. I've worked in the hospitality industry for the last like 10 years. As soon as I was old enough to wait tables and serve, I've been doing that at the service level, waiting tables, bartending, even restaurant management. I've kind of dabbled in it all, but I always knew it was not something that I wanted to grow in because I've seen what restaurant managers do and how many hours they have to work, and it was never a lifestyle that I really wanted long-term for me. So it was always kind of like a stepping stone, like this is where, you know, I knew this wasn't it, but this was making the money and paying the bills at the time. So I never really got out of it. I kind of got stuck in that rut. I was never passionate about it. I was just good at it, and it paid the bills. And then when my husband and I moved to the Philly area about a year ago, we really didn't have any friends here, had no network, social network to build a business or to build a network to get a job here. We moved here for his job, so he was employed. But I spent several months trying to find a job doing anything else other than waiting tables because I was just so committed to not going back. And I couldn't find anything, and I have a degree in business management and couldn't find anything in an office, nothing, no business related anything that I could get
involved with. And so I was really frustrated and really feeling like really worthless and really struggling with just my own value, and just all the rejection and failure was really getting to me after several months of trying to find a job with no real leads. And that's kind of when I decided to take my health into my hands. We found out in the, like, at that bottom for me that we were pregnant, and that's really exciting, and it was something that we wanted. So it would definitely gave me that kick in the butt to move forward and get excited about life and know that, you know, there is a purpose for me, and it might be not being a career right now. It's going to be a mom right now. But so we started on that path, and, a few months into my pregnancy, I realized, like, I was sick and tired all the time, and I didn't want to be that way, and I didn't believe that just because I'm pregnant, I'm supposed to be sick and tired and miserable and just complain all the time. I knew that that's not how God designed it to be, so I wanted something more, so that's when I started eating better, and that's when I found Pio, started doing those workouts. I did them up until about 8 months pregnant, and I felt great. My doctors were so impressed every time I'd go in that I wasn't swelling, that I had energy, that I was happy and excited. I wasn't complaining. And so it was really like, the chance transformed me, like, physically. I wasn't necessarily, you know, getting abs obviously while I'm, building a baby inside me. But I was really working on, myself and my own nutrition and my physical appearance. And what's so great is, and what attracted me to this business is that, it doesn't just focus on, health, like your physical health as well. Like, it focuses so much when you're a coach, we're going to talk about this later, but building who you are and building up yourself along the journey. So, you know, as you become a, you know, better looking version of yourself and a better, healthier version of yourself, you're also growing your mind and focusing on making yourself more attractive, you know, mentally and more intelligent, and really just building yourself up to help sustain those things, so you're not a beautiful, shallow person in the end of it. It's really helped me to, like, really push myself to learn more and just become a better, well-rounded human being, I think, in general. And so it's been great to be in this business to be able to push that forward, and now be able to help other women, and a couple of men too, including my husband and some of our friends as well. But it's been great to be able to focus on just helping build other people up so they can experience that too, because I really just want everybody to be able to experience what I have so far with this business. So that's a little bit about us, just to get you a little bit. I know we could go on and on and on about our stories. We're all really passionate about why we do this. But we've got so much great stuff I want to get through. So we're going to dive right in here. So typically we just want to, like, go over real quick, the three different, like, routes that most people, or I guess two different routes that most people, at least most Americans take today, is that we go to college. Like, we're all told, our generation is all told now, you got to go to college. Like, it's not like, are you going to go? It's you go to college. Most people our age now have a 4-year degree. And that's typically, you know, without even thinking about it, we spend, you know, that says that the average tuition, that's for the America as a whole. So that's about $40,000, to get a 4-year degree. And that's an investment in yourself that you're making, and we're all kind of just told you need to make it. Like, this is what you do. You go to college and you make this investment, and we all kind of make that investment expecting, you know, to get that great job at the end of that 4-year contract or 4-year, you know, 4-year degree in school. But as so many, and I can attest to this because I have that 4-year degree, so many people in our generation are not able to use that degree. Because so many of us went to college and got those degrees. Randy, you can speak to that too. There's no guarantee to a job afterward. And it's ridiculous today. It's almost like half the people, like, I'm so excited for those who have been able to go on to grad school or who know exactly what they want to do and push that direction and really are passionate about it. But for those of us who got the degree because we knew it was the right thing to do, I guess, we're kind of like, okay, well, now what? I can't get a job in my field. And maybe, you know, you got your 4-year degree and you don't really want to get a job in that field now that you understand it better. So we all kind of make that investment and we really don't, there's no job guarantee at the end. But there's an investment in yourself there, 40 grand. So another option here is working an hourly job. And
here as J-O-B, as in just above broke, because that's what most America is. You're making just enough to pay the bills, maybe save a little bit, maybe go on vacation here and there, but you're not living life by design. You are not in that, you know, top 20% of Americans making, you know, the big bucks. You're making enough to feed your family and take care of basic needs. And that's most of America. And the average American salary here, it's about $45,000 a year. You get about 11 vacation days, and you've got, you're working, you know, about, that's like 50 weeks a year you work. And that's typically like 9-to-5, 8-to-4 type job. And that's what most of America is doing right now. And then you move on, and then there's the select few that have that entrepreneurial drive, and it's become really popular now to start a franchise. And those, the average cost to get into that, and that's just to buy the branding for it, is going to be $35,000. And that's average. They all vary differently. And by franchise, I'm talking like Subway or Mary Maids or Sweet Frog or there's so many different franchises out there now. But that also, just like that $35,000 buy-in is literally just to purchase the brand, to be able to use it, to use all of their marketing products and all of their name and their recipes and their services and their structure, their corporate structure, everything like that they've already placed out for you. You still have to pay on top of that for a brick-and-mortar building or a lease, whatever it is that you need to do to be able to run that business. And then it says here the average profit for franchisees is about $65,000 a year. So they're not, I mean, they're doing better than the average American on that salary. And that's, you know, they're doing pretty well for their family, and they're, you know, considered above average with income. So along with that franchise model, that's kind of what we want to compare what coaching is kind of like. And I'm hitting the wrong button with my slide. There we go. So what if you could own a franchise for $40? So we're going to compare it on a couple different aspects here, what a franchise looks like next to what Beachbody Coaching is. So with a franchise, the first risk that you're going to have is cash, and that can be between $10,000 and over up to $200,000 that you're going to pay. And a lot of people mortgage their houses and their homes and other property and other like family assets they have and savings accounts, retirement accounts. They risk all of that to be able to support this dream, to be able to build this franchise. And so with that, there's a lot of skin in the game. Like when you mortgage your house to build a business, you've got a lot at risk. And that means that's like the safety and health of your family. And the owner realizes that you have that serious interest, that you want to, like, having that kind of money invested makes you really push harder and make you really push to get that success level and not give up as easily as just the average employee that a franchisee might have. And with coaching, and some of the costs to sign up to coach, the investment here is $40 and then $16 a month thereafter. And that $40 fee can be waived completely if you have in the past or choose to purchase a challenge pack to get started. That fee will be completely waived for you. And the military and veteran spouses can all sign up completely for free as well. So that the risk to get involved here financially is really low. But because the risk is really low, it lowers the barrier to entry. So many people will sign up. But because you don't have a lot of skin in the game, it becomes a hobby for most people that join. So it can bring in some extra fun money here and there, but it's not going to bring in the serious income that's going to change your life unless you put the effort in. So the potential is completely limitless on what you can make, but you've got to be willing to put the effort in and the time in, even though you haven't necessarily put the money in. So that's where a lot of people don't necessarily work as hard as they would if they had mortgaged their home. But the people that are brave enough to just spend that $40 and push forward can really succeed in this business. Next, so benefits of being a franchisee is you get to, when you purchase a franchise, you're buying into an established, successful brand that is already nationally known, most likely. They spend money on national commercials. They've got recipes already done. They've done the research. They know what products their customers want. And you get access to all of that.
And so with that, the company takes care of the mainstream marketing, and the company itself takes on the risk of new product testing and development. And that's where coaching is exactly the same. Because when you're buying into Beachbody coaching, it is an established and successful brand already. You may not have heard of it labeled as Beachbody yet, but I guarantee you've heard of P90X or possibly Insanity. Our newest programs, Pio and 21 Day Fix are just flooding the markets. 21 Day Fix has sold more copies than I think any workout program that exists right now. Like, it's nuts. It's blowing all the records out of the water right now. And so our brand is known. Like, people know our products. And with that, Beachbody spends, this says $150+ million a year on mainstream marketing. If you're ever up late at night and you're flipping through channels, you're going to find a Beachbody infomercial for Beast or our newest 21 FX or Pio. You're going to see those. They spend so much money and have such high quality marketing already done for us. So to help create and then continue that brand awareness, to help make our products to where we just have to share them. We just have to let people know, hey, I can help you with that. I don't have to explain so much what Pio is or what 21 Day Fix is, because people understand our brand and understand what the products are already. And so next is for franchisees. This one's where we differentiate ourselves as well, because when you sign up as a franchise, you're given a guideline. You sign a contract that says, this is how I'm going to run my business, The Subway Club is made this way, and I have to make it this way. I can't, create my own Subway Club and call it that and make it a different recipe. Like, you've got to use their recipes, do it their way, and use all of their materials. You can't come up with your own strategies and ideas. You have to use everything that's given to you. So your success is really based on your own efforts and the people that you choose to hire to work for you to be able to manage all those guidelines. And for coaching, that's where it's awesome, because we have the ability to build our business. Like, each one of us, me, Brandy, Dina, all of us, and all the coaches on our team, each have our own individual businesses. I don't work, Brandy sponsored me to be in this business, but I don't work for her. I work for myself. I'm an independent business owner. And I get to brand my business however I want to. And I can design it to specifically speak to the women in my niche market, the women that I'm trying to target. I can speak to them directly. I don't have to be very broad. If you look at my Facebook account, hopefully, if you're friends with me and you're one of my coaches or someone that's been in one of my challenge groups, hopefully when you look at my Facebook page, it speaks to you and it gets you excited. And that's my goal. I'm not trying to reach a, 60-year-old man. Like, that's not my market. I'm not aiming to please him and make him happy with what he sees on my Facebook page. I don't really want him looking at my Facebook page. But we have that freedom to get to do it however we want. So, and with that, your success is linked on your efforts and the efforts of the team of coaches below us. Like I said, I don't work for Brandy, but when I succeed, it helps her business grow. And so we're still tied together in that way. So it gives it a really unique bond, and it kind of creates our own little mini sisterhood here, where her business isn't going to succeed unless mine does. So she's very vested in helping me to succeed and build my business as well. So it's really unique to Beachbody the way that structure works. So I'm going to hand it over to Dina, I think, and she's going to walk us through our next couple slides.
All right. So what do Beachbody coaches do exactly? What we do is we're helping inspire other people by just sharing our own journey, and hopefully it inspires them to start theirs. That's legitimately what this business is. You can try to make it complicated if you want, but we're just hoping that we're starting with ourselves and we're working on our own journey. And inviting maybe a couple of our friends and family members to join with us. And they inspire, and we inspire them, they inspire some more people, and then so on and so forth. So it's just sharing our own journey. We're not trying to trick anybody into doing anything. It's just sharing what we're doing right now. We also are helping people lose weight and become healthier and grow as a person too, by personal development. I think I mentioned that earlier, that's a huge part of this is that we are growing ourselves and making ourselves better. Yes, the physical appearance changes too, but we're growing better on the inside as well. And that hopefully attracts people to join in with us.
Can I change the slide?
Yeah. Should say next.
So this is how it works. If you see the pyramid, and that can be kind of scary, but we're not scared of this pyramid scheme thing at all, because we're going to tell you right now the truth about the business. When you start working on you and you start to inspire a few other people, you start to start their journey to inspire a few other people who then inspire a few other people. That's how the business. Yes, it does look like a pyramid, but we're going to take a look right now at other types of pyramids so you can kind of see that everything is so everything in our entire normal corporate structure is set up like a we have the CEO, and there's a few more managers, and there's a few more supervisors, ton of employees. Who makes the move? The person at the top, the CEO. And who makes the lead? The people at the bottom, the employee. So what's the likelihood that the people at the bottom ever become a CEO? Very small. So here is how people get confused about the business. There are some that their whole self-purpose is for you to recruit a lot of people and sign them up to pay about $500. They get a bunch of laptops and they sit in their garage and they never use them. You would get $500. So your sole intent is to go and sign as people as possible that will sign up ahead of you. So you can make about $250. And it basically means that's crazy. If not, it doesn't matter. Those companies exist. But here's the deal. With this company, when you sign up as a coach, we don't make a dime or even a sliver more than if you're signing up with us as a customer. So actually, in the second month, whenever you are doing the business, if we don't help you succeed as a coach, then we're actually going to lose money. So if we, the whole intent is for us to help those people who decide to sign up as coaches and succeed with the business to be able to effectively go start their own journey and inspire a few other people using social media correctly, and they'll be able to build their business and market to others. And we help them get started, because if we don't help them, then we lose time and money, because like I said, that second month, we're going to lose money from them not being a customer anymore, and they're wasting their time. So it's just all a big loss. So that's the difference between a pyramid, when you just are signing up a bunch of people, and where it sticks in the business. So I can truly tell you that we don't succeed unless our team succeeds. I hope that kind of makes sense to you guys. No one on this call is getting a big payout for signing up a bunch of people. When someone does choose to sign up with us, we have them fill out an application so we can understand what motivates them and what inspires them. Because for the first time, we're able to choose who we want to work with. We are our own bosses, and so we don't have to answer to anyone, and we want people on our team that have the same goals and drive that we have, and we want everyone to feel motivated and inspired. And that's really the most amazing thing, and that's the most unique part about Beachbody in this business. Okay.
All right. I'll take over. Cool. Awesome. Thanks. All right, so another part of, actually the three part of Beachbody is everything is together. The nutrition, the fitness, and the support. there's no one else that really has this done well. But this is also another hesitation that we get a lot from coaches when they first start or first want to start. You know, the nutrition part. Okay, do I need to have this huge degree in nutrition? Do I need to be a nutrition expert? Do I need to know the difference between quinoa and rice? No, you don't need to, because we've got the experts that are have already made all the meal plans and the nutrition aspects for our customers. Shakeology is taken care of. You know, our super dense nutritional meal replacement is done. You are set with that. You're drinking it. It's making you feel awesome. You're getting all your daily vitamins and nutrition. So that part's perfect. There's also meal plans and guides that come along with every program that we have. Even on the on-demand program, all of the things that we have on demand, which are our streaming live, not live, but streaming videos, there are also meal plans there as well. And our website that you get when you sign up as a coach, you get access to extra meal plans as well. As long, and also as being a part of our team, you get even more meal plans on top of that. So nutrition is covered. So to answer your questions or hesitations on the fact that you need to know anything about nutrition, no. Eventually you will learn more because you want to learn more to help your customers extra questions, but to start out, no. Fitness. Do I need to be in the fitness industry? Do I need to be a personal trainer? Do I need to even be on a journey, finish my journey, have six-pack abs, be the best of the best? Guys, no one is perfect. You can never be perfect. So no one wants to follow anybody who is perfect. So good luck trying, but we have got amazing trainers that are on our DVDs telling us what to do. They have spent years perfecting these moves and making these DVDs. So we can rest assured that the fitness aspect of this is taken care of as well. The only thing you need to be doing with the nutrition and fitness is pushing play and doing it yourself. So you are using these products. Same with the nutrition. Get your nutrition in line. Drink the Shakeology, and you're going to feel better and look better. And people are going to see that. And they're going to say, what are you doing? I want some of that. How easy is that? That's pretty much as easy as it gets. Peer support. This is where Beachbody has it under wraps. When they first started, this is something that wasn't really in existence. And they had a lot of people were starting chat boards and YouTube videos and things like that. And they were supporting each other through that way. And Beachbody caught on and formed Team Beachbody, which we are a part of as being coaches. So they brought us coaches on because they saw that support that people were finishing the programs because everybody was supporting each other. So with our challenge groups, that is an amazing aspect of this. Us being a coach, being able to support the challengers, on top of us supporting challengers, we're supporting each other as coaches. And you'll see that within our groups. So I'll talk a little bit more about what our team has to offer for coaching, but the three vital parts of being a challenger slash customer are your nutrition, fitness, and peer support, and it is covered. So feel rest assured that you are covered on all those aspects. Perfect. Yay. Next. Is this me? This me too. Okay, cool. All right. So having said that, again, if you're doing all those things, you're sharing your story, you're pushing play, you're drinking your Shakeology, you've got your nutrition in order, you're not selling. You are sharing your story, and people, like I said, are going to be automatically drawn to you. If people do not know that you have this to offer, then, of course, they're not going to come to you about it. So that's why we share. We share because we want to help people feel like we are feeling now. I feel amazing. My back is stronger. My nutrition has never been more on point. And my fitness is fantastic Because you know why? I've got all these eyeballs watching me, so it's extra support for me and accountability for me. So being a coach on top of just being a challenger is even more support from all of your challengers and all of your other coaches. So this screen here, this slide here, is talking about the top 10 resolutions that most people are making. You know, exercise being the number one. You know, we're not selling stuff that people don't want. These are all solutions to help help them be successful in achieving their goals on top of them being fitness. I mean, losing weight, quitting smoking, quitting drinking. I mean, all of these things, enjoying life more. Of course, when you're exercising, you get more endorphins. Endorphins don't, you know, makes you happy. Everybody's seen that movie. So again, do I have to sell stuff? We don't want to be salesy. It's icky. It's gross. I don't want to be a salesperson. And I sure hope that when you guys come to Stephanie Dina I's Facebook pages or any of that, you're not seeing salesy stuff. We are sharing our story and hoping that people will join us on our journey. And it's easy. That's easy peasy. I mean, I don't know how much more easier than it gets. So I'm not selling anything. I've got stuff to offer that people, it's a solution for people to have, but I don't feel slimy or awkward about what I'm doing because I'm super passionate. The fact that I know that these are products that work because why? I use them and I see that they work. So that's that. All right. So once you become a coach, which most of us on the call are or are wanting to be, how do you make the money? Because obviously we are in this to help everybody. Of course, that is our number one drive. If it is not, then I say you might want to look for something else because you are not going to be successful in this unless your heart is in the right spot. We are in this to help. Now, okay, we all have bills to pay. We know that we just can't give our lives away. We would love to, obviously, but rent's due, electricity, we kind of like light, hot water. So how do you make money? Now I'm showing you Lindsay Matway's screens and her pay of her past couple of years because she's been in this a lot longer than all three of us. So it'll give you more of a longer journey. So we felt that it would be better to show hers. So in the beginning, you're brand new. You just signed up as a coach. And you can see that, you know, maybe you sold something to one of your friends who saw you on, you know, on your journey. And they're like, hey, I want to do the 21-day fix with you. Let's do it. So you sell them a challenge pack. And you get 25% commission off of anything you're selling. Now, having said that, as being coaches, like Dina had said before, when we sign you guys as coaches, we're not making money off of you guys. We are building our team. So it gets a little bit more complicated. We'll tell you a little bit more about that in our groups and our challenge and our Emerald groups and things like that, all these support groups that we have for you. It's a little bit more complicated to explain than here. But just as a basis, you get your commission and eventually it turns into another, it turns into more of a team bonus, which is why we're talking about how we want to support you guys as coaches. So as an Emerald means you've signed on two people, you know, maybe your best friend, your mom, your husband, your wife, and you sign them two people up. That's all it takes to become Emerald. And once you hit Emerald, that's an awesome place to be because then you start getting team bonuses, which you can see a team bonus here of $14. That is one cycle. Which cycles are a little bit more complicated to talk about, but it's a very basic. Once you hit Emerald, you get a $14 team bonus. Once you hit Diamond, it becomes $18. There is a step in between there called Ruby, but most people skip over it, so that's why it's not here. Once you hit Star Diamond, you can see that her team bonus is starting to rise a little bit more, and commission is staying a little bit similar there. But this is where the magic happens. Once you're in for about a year, now everybody runs their business differently. If you are in this to win this and you are a business builder and you are determined and motivated, you can make this whatever you want to make it. That's the best thing about this job is that you can make it whatever you want. The harder you work, the more you're going to get out of it. So here in the year, her retail commissions are now lower than her team bonus. So this is showing you that she has spent time and money, not money, time and investment into her team. All of her efforts are now into her team, building her team up. Her teams are growing teams. So this is why a team bonus comes into play. Team bonuses are when we are building volumes on each of our teams, and we are now making cycles off that. So her being a diamond, she's making $18 a cycle. So it shows you how much her team is working hard. So again, building your team is a very important part of this. And looking into, 2.5 years, this is 1 week, guys, 1 week. And I'm not even going to begin to tell you, she's been in this for 5 years. What she's making, I don't even know what that money looks like. So to me, I am a big dreamer and I can dream there, but for this webinar, let's keep here that she's making $6,000 a week at 2.5 years. So what other business can you get into that you are helping people and making such a big earning from that? So I hope that helps a little bit. I know it's a little blurry on the in-depth of explaining what cycles are like, but we can talk to you guys that individually, and also you learn about that through our individualized trainings. So moving on.
Yeah, make sure you guys are muted because that's when we're getting the echo. Okay, so worst case scenario, if you sign up to be a coach today and no one wants to join you, you can't seem to inspire a single person to do this with you. So worst case scenario here, you've invested $40 in yourself. And you have been, with that $40, you've been connected to new, driven and inspiring friends on our team, as well as all of our challengers. If you've been involved yet in one of our challenge groups or even some of our free groups, you see the community that builds and how we are a group of women that's really, like, our goal here is to build each other up. And some of, just to build each other up in all different aspects of our lives. We're trying to help each other, build stronger friendships and marriages and businesses and helping, support each other. When we, there are days that I don't want to work out. Just don't think that I wake up every day like, yes, I get to work out today. So we all need that. And just by joining in as a coach, you get that accountability because you got all those eyes watching you. So you get connected. Next, you get to focus on yourself and get healthier in general. So you invested that money, and so you've got a challenge pack per se. So you are working out and you are eating well. You're following a meal plan. You are getting yourself in better shape physically. Like, that's for $40. Yes, please. And then the last one here is that you get to start facing your fears head on, and you're growing as a person because you'll like I told you before, one of the things we focus on as coaches is we're constantly building ourselves up. We are reading personal development books on, things that we know that we struggle with, like time management. Who doesn't struggle with time management? Or how to share and not sell, and all the different things that we're trying to work on. We're reading books and audiobooks and watching YouTube videos, constantly trying to grow ourselves and put ourselves out of our comfort zone. So if you join as a coach, that's what we're going to encourage you to do too. We're going to push you out of your comfort zone. So if you join and you can't make a dollar, you've spent $40, you've invested in yourself, you've created new healthy habits, and you've built some great friendships. And know that with those friendships, if you choose not to be a coach, those friendships are still there. We still like you. We love you. We know this isn't for everybody. We just want to share it with everybody because we know that it's such an incredible opportunity, and we know what it's done for us so far. So I'm going to hand it over to Dina.
So there's three different types of coaches. Not everyone's like us, gotta make it work, devouring information and wanting to be successful. There's a discount coach,
So if you like drinking Shakeology on a regular basis, it helps you save money on that. You can drink it zero sales, and you're still just saving $16 a month just by being a discount coach. And then we have a hobby coach. So you have a full-time job. You love the products. You enjoy sharing them with others, and you love some extra spending money. Like, who doesn't like to go splurge every now and then on some extra spending money? And then there's the business builders, which is what we are. We're all in. We're going to make this. They have it as their full-time job. I'm eventually going to make it my full-time job. We're building a life of freedom, and we're thriving. We're on a thriving team that is doing the same. And then there's also some people that start off as discount coaches, and then their friends ask them about what they're doing, and they begin to be in that middle zone. So there's all different types of coaches, and you can fall in between either one of them. It's just really up to you how you want to work the business.
All right, so... Can you hear me? Am I unmuted? Nope. Am I unmuted now? Can you hear me? Okay. So what our team provides, like I was saying with the slide earlier, we provide our one-on-one trainings, which we'll go in more depth of what, how the cycles work and how pay is more, there's a lot of bonuses and, I mean, there are trips that we qualify for, Success Club trips. We have a summit coming up in July in Nashville that you can qualify for if you hit Success Club for the first 3 months of your business, which is awesome. So much training there. Beachbody is so set up for success. They want to see succeed because obviously we are the ones who are evangelizing the products. You know, we're using these products. It's just a bunch of walking advertising mints because we are so excited about the products. We want to tell everybody, obviously. We do weekly training calls every Wednesday night. That's when they're set right now. We put extra information in there for you guys, more training, more in-depth learning. Also, another way that we can all kind of get together and chat, which is really nice. One-on-one trainings with your coaches between the three of us here, you would get trained personally. Small group trainings and apprenticeships with a huge proven step-by-step success trainings. We have one going on right now, Coach Camp, which is 21 days of learning how to start your business. We've got Coach to Emerald, so how to get to an Emerald rank, and Emerald to Diamond once you hit Emerald. So as you can see, we do not leave you in the dark. We are not just, hey, come on in, and then peace. We want you guys to succeed because we see what this is doing in our lives. We definitely want to see you guys be able to pay it forward and duplicate it for you guys as well. We do, I guess we do a lot of one-on-one trainings, kind of second line there on that. We do social media training because I know a lot of people aren't used to being on social media. Kind of tell you a little bit tricks of the trade. I know I've done a couple for tonight, but not on this call, but for some coaches. Countless video trainings. We've got manuals on different learning speeds and preferences. The system of support is amazing. I mean, we are here 24/7. I am constantly on Facebook chat. You can text me, you can call me, and the same with all the girls here. We are here for you. And again, just so much more. This is just a place that we really want to see you guys dream and succeed in those dreams and dream big. Why not? Why not you? Why not us? Why can't we dream big? We can make $6,000. We can help 1,000 people, you know. However, it's so attainable. It's just how much you want to put into it. And again, we are okay with if you just want to be a discount coach, that's fine. Discount coaches, they get their Shakeology, they do their programs, fantastic. They're some of our best challengers. That's great. why not get a discount on that? If you're a hobby coach, like Dina was saying, get a little bit extra cash, help a couple people here or there, have someone join you on your journey so you're not alone at home doing it. You know, you've got the challenge groups to join in, but when you've got a face-to-face and someone's there saying, hey, so did you do your workout today? Even more accountability. More training. So I was telling you about Lindsay and when you saw her income. She founded this back in about 5 years ago, 2010. She started pretty much from scratch. Her person who she was signed up underneath no longer works the business. She never really worked the business. So she has done this all on her own, has made training manuals, has built a team. She's got 40,000 coaches underneath her right now. And all of that is, they've just worked and restructured and made manuals and systems of duplication for us that we have direct access to. And she's been in the top 10 for the past 5 years in a row. So she's doing something right, and she is paying that forward to straight into our team. So we have all of that access to that. Am I saying that word right? Access to that point, to that information. You guys know what I mean. We've got the information to help you guys grow and succeed. And her team motto, which is our team motto, because we are all part of the Bombshell Dynasty, is together we are better. Because why not? Iron sharpens iron. We are here to lift everybody up. We're not going to succeed if you guys don't succeed. So it's all one big circle of success. And now what? Now what? You've been on this call. Thank you very, very much. We are so appreciative that you guys have been here. What do you do now? You want to message the person who invited you to this call. Me, Stephanie, Dina, whoever invited you, message them. What kind of coach do you want to be? You may have changed your mind since you've been here. You know, maybe you've been a discount coach. Maybe it's like, wow, maybe I could make this a little bit of a hobby, just something on the side. You know, I've got a busy job. I've got kids. You know, maybe I can work this into my schedule. And let us walk you through the sign-up process because it's super easy. Most of you guys are already coaches, but if there's somebody that you know that thought you think maybe this might be something that they want to do, let's sign them up underneath you, you know, because that way you can start growing your team and you can help them be held accountable and help them grow in their journey. If you guys do want to be a business builder or a hobby coach, please let us know because we have a new training group opening up this month. As soon as this next one finishes, we're going to have another one opening up. So please let us know and we will get you signed up and dialed into that right away. And then on top of that, if you want to be an apprentice coach with one of us, we can get you working into a new challenge group and you can start running it alongside of us. All of this are baby steps. We are here to, if you want to run, we will run with you. I am ready. I love to run and let's run. But if you want to, you know, take it slower, walk, even that's just as fine as well. But again, there are all different types of speeds and we are here for you on however you want that speed to be. But if you want to come on in and be an apprentice, we can show you how to run a challenge group. Most of you guys have already been in a challenge group. That's why we love that our coaches are in the challenge groups. So they already see how it's running. But if you want to see a little bit more of the back of the house and how we do more for that, just let us know. If you guys have questions, so is there a difference in the opportunity if you are a hobby builder or business builder? I'm not sure if I... Stephanie, do you want to answer that? I'm not sure if I understand all the way.
He answered it in the chat.
Oh, did we? Okay. So, Autumn, it moves, you just move a little bit slower. It's you know, you're not really dialed in and super focused. You have some other things going on and you just want to build it a little bit slower. That's fine. That's what a hobby is. none of these cost differently. If you're a hobby builder or a business builder, it's not that you have to pay more into it. It's all the same. Everybody pays same. Everybody does the same. It's just how much more